Welcome everyone, welcome to Thinking in Utopia. I'm Diego, I'm a psychology student who is reflecting on diverse topics about tech or social interactions and what we are living today. I will also talk about my experience and some thoughts of studying abroad. I studied abroad in the Netherlands at Radboud University, or in Dutch will be Radboud University. Sorry if I mispronounce the name. Honestly, I can't speak Dutch. The Dutch is really difficult, but it's a beautiful language. So studying abroad is important. I think that is something important because it brings you new experiences. Because it's not only the opportunity to visit new places, it's also the opportunity to interact with people from different cultures, to hang out with them, to live a new way of living life, because every country has their own way of living the life. So hang out with friends from different countries, go to new places, meet new people, see the traditions that they have there, and also to try to learn a new language, because I think that it's kind of important to try to speak a little bit of the, if you can speak the language of the country where you are going, that's amazing. But if not, I will recommend you to try to have some words. But honestly, I didn't learn Dutch. I was there for a few period of time and it was really difficult. But the Dutch people speak really good, really, really well the English. So you will not have any problems because of that. And actually, the Dutch people are really kind. So when they see that you are struggling with the Dutch, they tell you, if you want, we can speak in English. And maybe you will say, yes, please, because, I don't know, you are in the mall and you need to go to the stores and all that stuff, right? So yeah, and it was really funny. I went abroad last year in 2020. So also I lived the COVID outbreak there, and that was also an interesting phenomenon. I would like to talk a little bit more in this video about that. But first, when you're in another country, almost everything looks interesting, from riding the subway. To walking down the street, and those little things that are a part of the new experience. And by the way, the Airbnb where I stayed a night before they gave us our apartment, it was really, really nice. Just look at this. It was a lovely place. And I have to tell you that they have amazing marketing. Just look at this banner. If this is not good marketing, I don't know what it is. Yeah, and the city where I was living is the city of Nijmegen. I understand that is the one of the ancient cities there in the Netherlands. I think that is the ancient city there. And it was really funny because when we try to pronounce the name of our residences, we will do something like, where are you living? Where are you living at? And you will say something like, Buxtehof. Where? Buxtehof. Where? Buxtehof. And the people will be, as I told you, really, really kind, because they have a lot of patience when we pronounce something really bad, because also the pronunciation of the Dutch is really, really different of what we are used to. So yeah, but they are really kind people and they will help you with almost everything. And I'm saying this a lot in this video, but honestly, the Dutch people are really kind. They honestly arrange everything for our arrival. So when we went to the city, they will took us from the central station to the university, to our apartments. And actually you have the opportunity to take an orientation week where they will put you with another people from different countries and you will make a team. And you will have some mentors that will show you places of the city, where to go. You will hang out with them to go to pubs. And it was a cool experience, honestly. I took that orientation week and it was something amazing. And the city was beautiful. Just look at the view I had from my room. Beautiful, right? And the university was next level. Not only because of the aesthetic of the buildings, but also because of the level of the courses. Actually, I have with me here my hoodie. Yeah, look at that. Really cool, right? At the university. And I know that this may look nerdy, but honestly, I don't care. I really like it. And I almost reaching the point of the reflection where I wanted to go, that I wanted to do. So here it goes. When I was there, I had the opportunity to take a course of artificial intelligence. And as you may know, I'm a student of psychology, so maybe you are wondering what I was doing there. Well, I think that the future of a lot of disciplines will be affected by the new tools and opportunities that the artificial intelligence is creating. And in this course, which had the name Brain, the course was named Brain, it was a really nice name, we explore how the AI can benefit from neuroscience and how neuroscience can benefit from AI. Really exciting, right? And these new opportunities and tools that the machine learning artificial intelligence is creating is no different for psychology. Actually, to understand the mind, the artificial intelligence will be needed. Basically, because the brain is so complex and incredible that we need the computational power of the new algorithms and the new tools that are emerging in the disciplines. What a paradox, right? Because to understand our brain and our intelligence, we need to recreate it with artificial intelligence in order to help us to understand our mind and our brain. It's fascinating, right? To understand the mind and intelligence, we need to create a replica of kind of a replica. I mean, it's really different. The artificial intelligence is not as we have a physical brain. It's kind of different in many, many ways. First, because we don't know right now how exactly the brain and the intelligence works. We have a lot of knowledge, but the knowledge in the discipline of the mind is changing at a high speed. Honestly, we will see really interesting years. But now, how this AI thing is related to the reflection I wanted to do and to study abroad? Well, my reflection is, as I told you before, right now we can do a lot of things partially alone because of the internet, you can arrange everything to study in another country on the internet. You can reserve, you can book your Airbnb online, you can book your flights, you can buy stuff on the internet, you can even find the medical center that you need to do if you're in another country. You can do a lot of things by yourself on the internet. You can start a YouTube channel by yourself because of the computational power that now we have. And this new way of living and to do things is changing all the world around us. And that will bring some new experiences and jobs and consequences in the future. It's not that we can do everything by ourselves. I don't think that we can do everything by ourselves. We always need someone to give us even an opportunity, right? So yeah, it's not like by doing everything by yourself, you will be better than doing some things with some people. I'm not saying that you should be in one other extreme that only live for interact with people, and the other extreme that only live to be alone. No, I think that it's like most of the things, the answer is kind of in the middle, right? But right now we have a lot of tools and techniques that we can use because of the internet, because of the computational power, because all this stuff, and we can do a lot of things right now. And for example, for me, my experience of studying abroad was really good because it was not something like I knew that I could check on the internet and I could research everything that I needed if I will encounter myself in a extreme situation, right? But obviously, as I told you, it's not the same to be in your classroom, to be in another country, learning a new language, hang out with new people, going riding a bike, because in the Netherlands we went everywhere with in our bikes, and it is something amazing. I mean, there is like highways for bikes that are really, really well designed. So the experience of riding a bike from your residence to university is something unique. At least for me, it was something that I think that can improve the quality of life a lot. Yeah, who will imagine, right, that a bike could do that? Because you can, I have to cross like a kind of a forest to go to arrive to go to my university from where I was living at, and it was an amazing riding because I was looking on the nature, listening to music. It was a really cool experience. And as I told you, when I was there, the COVID-19 outbreak happened when I was there in the Netherlands. So it was, that was also an incredible experience, full of uncertainty. So in the middle of the semester, all of our courses went online, and the mandatory quarantine was declared. So at that time, a lot of friends decided to go back to their countries, because there were a lot of uncertainty. And just 2 weeks after that outbreak, I decided to do the same. I went back because we couldn't go out till the end of the semester, and all of our courses were online. And I was paying month by month my rent. So for me, it was like, because I will be locked up in this room for months and I will be paying that rent, I think that I could go back and don't pay a lot of money, right? But so I decided to do that. I didn't see the benefits of staying at home at my room there because all of my friends were gone. They decided to go back to their countries. It was a really, really incredible experience. By the way, if you want to know why people could decide to stay alone in a room or a home for months and years, I have a video here which is about the experience of living confined and the hikikomoris. So if you are interested in that, check out that video. So going back to the video, and actually I remember like 2 days before the mandatory quarantine, I was in a pub with a lot of friends from different places, and there were a lot of uncertainty. Actually, we didn't even enjoy the hangout because we were all talking about what is this COVID thing, what could happen. Is this something more extreme that it looks right now? It was weird. There were weird times, most because we had to decide if we will stay in the Netherlands or if we will go back, right? And I decided to go back, the same as a lot of my friends. So yeah, that was an incredible experience. But some of my thoughts on this is that if you have the opportunity to study abroad, don't wait till the end of your bachelor's degree. Do it. Is an incredible experience because you will meet a lot of new people, you will know different ways of living, and also interact with people from other countries, because I saw a lot of people that only interact with the people of their country, and I think that that's necessary. We need that support. We need to have a group of support that maybe speak our own language. But one of the best things of going abroad is to talk, to know a lot of people from different places, know what they are thinking, how is their lives, and all this stuff. And I think that it's something really, really cool. And also the importance of the internet, the AI in our daily lives right now, because even in a pandemic, we could arrange everything that we need for our departure. And that's something that some years ago, like maybe some 30, imagine 30 years ago being in a crisis like that in another country, maybe you will be stuck in that country, right? And you maybe, I don't know, your life will change completely because everything is changed completely because of the COVID-19, not only because all the consequences that it has create, but because of the new automation that this phenomenon is creating. Right now, we are experiencing a lot of what will be the future. I mean, not all the education will be online, but a lot of it will be, and a lot of the jobs will be online. And actually, I want to do a video of that, my reflections on online education, but well. So yeah, I think that's kind of it. If you have the opportunity, do it. Do your research. You have all the tools in the internet to accomplish that. And yeah, also let's see how the automation will be in this year, this 2021, and in the next years. So, well, hope you enjoyed the video. If you reach till this part of the video, first, thank you. I remember you that the English is not my first language, so I'm trying to improve it while making these videos. So I'm sure that I made some mistakes when I'm talking, but yeah, I think that can be understandable. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. See you in more videos. Stay safe.